Yes, the Ace and Cobra 3 are already in the house. Give us a week or two to test and review them. Today, I'll show you how we personalize some plain metal bottles and flashlights from AliExpress using the rotary roller that came with my AlgoLaser DIY Mini 10 Watt Diode Laser. With Christmas around the corner, these could make great gifts. I'm Gergo, and this is Gergo Print 3D, our YouTube channel about not only 3D printing, but also laser projects and other fun DIY. Remember to enable the carefully prepared translation-ready subtitles if you need them. Over the past few months, I've introduced a few laser machines, tempting some of you to try laser cutting and engraving alongside 3D printing. Apparently it worked. Someone recently asked which accessories I'd recommend bundling with a first engraver. First on my list is the software LightBurn. Think of it as a slicer for lasers. After a 30-day trial, you'll need a license, but it's actually cheaper if bundled with your device. I got mine from geekbuying.com along with my first larger laser machine. Second would be an enclosure and venting system, or like us, you could operate in an open space, mine set up on my porch. Finally, I recommend getting a rotary attachment. From our experience, it's well worth the investment. Today's footage was gathered over the last couple of months. We attempted to customize these black painted bottles twice, with growing success. We used a similar approach on cylindrical metal flashlights too, but engraving this stainless steel bottle worked a bit differently. For black painted objects, the laser etches away the paint to reveal shiny aluminum or steel underneath. My AlgoLaser DIY Mini's 10 watt diode laser was plenty strong, set at 70 to 80% power and 2500 millimeters per minute speed. Check out my review of the device in this earlier video. These 600 milliliter black bottles are really inexpensive on AliExpress. I got them for under $3. I link to the seller in the description below. Before diving into the bottles, here's a tip. The toilet paper roll returns. Remember how we used it with my SU8? This time we use it to test our setup, and you'll see why it's so helpful. First, we loosen the belt on the rotary attachment, adjust the rollers for the item's size, then reset the belt tension. Then we use four wooden blocks to raise the engraver, allowing space for both the rotary roller and the object beneath the moving laser head. With the object rotating along the Y-axis, we only need the laser to move along the X-axis. To set up, open LightBurn and adjust the machine settings following the instructions in the booklet. First, read in and save the current non-rotary base settings, which we'll be able to reload for flat objects later. Then disable the homing cycle, and in the protected section, change the Y stepper value from 100 to 80. Save these as rotary settings and write them to the device for this setup. Turn off the engraver, connect the rotary motor by unplugging the Y axis motor and plug in the rotary accessory in its place. Straightforward, right? Quick note though, order matters here. Powering on with the homing cycle still enabled and the rotary motor connected will trigger an error signal. The two aren't compatible, as homing wouldn't be able to finish without the end stops. Next, we measure the width of our work area. My digital caliper's circumference mode gives the length directly, though you could also just multiply the diameter by pi. If you haven't yet, get yourself a caliper like this, order it with the other supplies. Link to a quality yet inexpensive option below. I set this work area at the origin on a tool layer in LightBurn, added my channel logo as a test and adjusted the power and speed for the paper roll. Note, only use fills, not offset fills or lines, to ensure smooth single direction rotation. Then we align the laser head with the object and set focus. With the homing cycle disabled, the laser head stays in position when turned on. Running the test, I saw my logo was backwards. The rotary roller was facing the wrong way. Testing with a paper roll saved us from ruining the actual bottle. Now we could move on to the bottle. We designed a grayscale image of our favorite video game, GigaBash, which took about 3 hours to engrave. The image looked even better after rubbing it with a damp cloth, but we learned a few things. Higher contrast images like black and white line graphics work best. Since the bottle's black areas turn shiny when engraved, be sure to invert the image colors. We didn't. With these lessons learned though, our second bottle turned out perfect. Wiping it down brought out the engraving's real shine. We also engraved these flashlights from AliExpress in the same way, each turning out great. My nephew's has Naruto eyes, while mine features a Bible verse, to each their own. They are rechargeable and very strong. We can only recommend them. Link to these below the like button as well. The like button. Lastly, we tackled this stainless steel bottle, which cost about twice as much as the black ones, but is still very budget friendly. Testing on the cap, I used 100% power at 1800 millimeters per minute for the darkest engraving. This time, there's no need to invert the images since the edged parts will become dark. A tricky part, I started with a small logo on the cap that came out distorted. I left the cap on and rotated the larger bottle, so I had to account for the bottle circumference to avoid distortion. So, adjust the design's length based on the circumference of the cap, then stretch it further to match the circumference of the bottle actually touching the rollers. With this trick, the rest of my logo engraved perfectly on the cap, though I wish I had flipped it the other way. Engraving the rest of the bottle took a few hours, and I did manage to mess up slightly along the way. I opened a new project in Lightburn, forgetting it was still connected to the engraver and controlling it in real time. Unlike some engravers that can store jobs in memory and run them locally, this one doesn't have that feature. Luckily, I could resume the engraving, and even with this little mishap, the stainless steel bottle turned out fantastic. Where the laser hit, the metal surface dimpled slightly, adding a tactile feel to the letters. I could have used a bit less power to avoid this, but I actually like the effect. The final verdict? Absolutely get a rotary attachment for your laser. Usually, it's just a small extra cost when bundled, and it unlocks so many possibilities. You can't engrave glass with a diode laser, but these metal bottles, flashlights, and tumblers make great personalized gifts or even company merch. Speaking of glass, stay tuned. We'll soon cover glass and transparent acrylic engraving using the Onyx RCO2 laser from Monport. Watch my laser reviews and projects in this playlist, or check out our 3D printing playlist if that's more your thing. I hope you'll join us next time as we go print 3D. And thank you for watching another Gergo Print 3D video all the way to the end.